the body's on fire. Ooh, love me long till you get tired. Ooh, baby, you got what I use a real one, I'm inspired.
People say yeah, yeah, yeah. I can put you in a log cabin somewhere in Aspen. Girl, ain't nothing to the pain, ain't tricking if you got it, what you asking for. Put you in a mansion somewhere in Wisconsin. Like I said, ain't nothing to the pain, we can change that last name, what's happening? 'Cause you look so good, tell me why you wanna work here. I put you on the front page of a King magazine, but you gon' get yourself hurt.
Hey guys, welcome to Hawaii vlog. I actually don't even know how much I'm gonna vlog. I'm in my room, I just got dressed. Let me flip this camera around. Okay. I don't know how to flip it around. Hold on. There we go. This is the outfit of the day. It's just this black dress. I am super bloated and on my menstrual. I didn't even pack really to be for my menstrual because technically I should be going off, but I'm just like, yeah, that's not the case right now. And I don't know what shoes I'm gonna wear. but I only have two to choose from, so either black or black. Might change my earrings. I have these glasses on because my eye is swollen. So, yeah, let me go sit down. Tell y'all what goes on with me and my eye. So, for whatever reason, when I go on trips, my eye gets swollen, and I don't understand why. This is only my second day here. We got here yesterday early. I was fine until in the middle of the night, my eye started itching. I'm like, Lord, please. And normally it doesn't, before it didn't itch, it would just like pop up swollen. But last year when I went to Dominican Republic, it happened. And I thought it was due to stress because my luggage was stolen. I never got it back. So I was there the whole time with no luggage. So I was thinking, you know, I'm stressed and all of that. Here, I'm not really stressed. Only thing that's bothering me is my menstrual being on. But that's life. So I don't know what's going on and why it's doing that. So let me see. You can see, and it's the same eye. This one is a little swollen, but it's that one. And this is just day two. On my trip last year, it got really swollen to the point that I couldn't even open my eye. So I'm hoping that doesn't happen. But yeah. So yeah, don't know how much talking I will be doing or like facing the camera. It'll probably just be a bunch of I can't even think right now, but clips of the island and everything like that. But yeah, that's it. I'm a little bummed out by that because I just don't know. Like, why does this happen on trips? It happened before when I went to LA. Don't know why. It happened. It first happened when I went to we did like an RV stay. I hated it. And I feel like that stressed me out. I was crying and everything. I feel like that stressed me out and made my eyes swollen. But yeah. I just don't know. I asked the doctor about it. She didn't know. Like, it's just a weird symptom. I don't know, but it ruins my trip. Like, I can't even get cute. I gotta walk around with glasses on. Hopefully, I can continue to put my contacts in. Because it's not the inside of my eye that's affected. It's just the outside. So, gotta go get some Benadryl. Although, that does not help. Maybe it'll help with the itching. I have some hydrocortisone that I put on it. Anyway, this is day one. I just got out the shower, about to eat. My sister and one of the other women, they went to go get breakfast for me, and the other sister, we decided to sleep in because it's a 6-hour difference. So, although we all were up early, it was just, yeah. I woke up at like 3. My sister woke up at like 2. But I went back to sleep. She never went back to sleep. So, speaking of that, it is 8:33 a.m. here. So, that means it's 2:33 at home. So, yeah. But I'm about to eat breakfast, and then we have our first adventure today, which is the Pearl Harbor adventure. We only have 2 things booked. The other days are just 3 days. So yeah, I'm rambling per usual because this is probably all the talking I'm gonna do unless my eye gets better. This is the view from the balcony. That's the beach. We're right on the beach. Oh my god, that bird. Oh my god. Anyway, we're right on the beach. And then it's just buildings. Yeah. We don't have the best view, but it's so nice out here. It feels so good. Still swollen, still itchy, but yeah, so we're just chilling, about to order some pizza, have some wine, and probably just walk around the resort. Just a lot to see on this resort, so we'll do that. I got some footage at the Pearl Harbor. I don't know what to call that. It's not an excursion. So we were under the impression that it was like some type of boat ride, but literally you just ride from one point of the Pearl Harbor to the next, which is like not even 5 minutes, and then you go in and you see the memorial. And that was it. It was a very somber place, which was to be expected, very sad. But yeah, it just wasn't what we thought it was gonna be. And then we did a tour of downtown, Waikiki Island, which is not far from us. And yeah, Hawaii is beautiful. It's really nice here. It is expensive. I spent so much money at their ABC stores. It's crazy. Just getting like personal stuff that I didn't think I would need, but yeah, so that's that. But it is nice. I might just chill out for a while. They went to go get the pizza, And I'm just gonna relax for a bit. I got me some Benadryl though, so hopefully by the time I wake up, my eye is better. We shall see. But I'll talk to you guys later. Good morning. It's Thursday. Happy Thursday from Hawaii. It is 7:55 a.m. over here. I've been up since I think like 5:30-ish. Yeah. Still trying to get acclimated. I went to bed at like 9 something. And my eye is going down a little, so I've just been putting hydrocortisone on it, and I took 2 Benadryl last night. And I did not put my face on the pillow when I slept. I just kind of did like that. I mean, I don't really know the reason that my eye does this, but yeah. So I'm just up right now. Don't know what I'm about to do besides probably go get some breakfast and some coffee. I don't know if I mentioned, but the Starbucks, oh my God, that coffee was so good. I might have mentioned it, but I want some more, and I didn't buy it. My sister bought it, so I don't know who made it, but I need to know who made that coffee. It was so good. Because you know how Starbucks has like a burnt taste? It didn't have that. So, yeah, so right now I'm about to edit my video. It's my sister now. So I'll check back in later. Okay, so that was my sister. We're about to go get some breakfast. She just did a yoga class. And while she did that, I hopped in the shower. So I'm about to go get some breakfast and I'll come back in a little bit. what I'm wearing to the luau later. Just this flowy floral dress that I got years ago from H&M. I wish it had pockets. That would be perfect, but... And I don't know what shoes I'm going to wear. It's either going to be... It's either going to be these Zara slip-ons or these dad sandals from ASOS. So yeah, don't know. And just my regular jewelry. These are from, I forgot. It's all black owned though. These are, I think these are Vosh official smiley bracelet from, let me zoom in. Can you see it? Smiley bracelet from The Laugh Style. This faux tennis bracelet from something icon, something. It's black owned though. Rings is garnish and gold and Henry something. That's not, I don't think that's black owned, but yeah. That's it. I'm just in the room relaxing. I'm probably about to sit out on the balcony because it's cold in here. Just to warm up a bit, but bye for now. Just trying to get out here to warm up a bit before I go back inside. I don't feel like sitting out here either. Can't get in the water. It's like every vacation. For the past, since 2017, it's a fly. He just noticed me. Girl, get your ass. Every vacation that I've been on since 2017, all except for one, I've been on my menstrual. Like, why can't I just enjoy vacation without being on my menstrual? Only one, and that was 2 years ago when I went to Mexico, and I had a time that I was able to get in the water every day. Prior to that, every single vacation, like, I don't understand. No matter when it's booked, I don't even, because it's hard to even figure out when my cycle is going to be on. And, you know, don't nobody care about that, though. Especially when you book them way in advance, you can think your cycle won't be on, but then things switch up, so. Just got me bummed out a little bit. I have been enjoying myself, but yeah. On another note, they have an inglot store on this resort, and I think I'm gonna go in there to get my eyeliner, because it's so hard to get inglot that eyeliner anywhere. The last time I purchased it is when I was in Dubai. We don't have the store, like the Inglot store where I live. And they had that store in Dubai. And I think I was able to order it once from Macy's. And then when I tried to order it again, they canceled my order because it said something about either it couldn't ship or they sold. It was something weird. And then I know I saw it on Amazon, but I just don't be trusting, like, Amazon products like that, so. But yeah, I'm definitely going to get that before I leave. It really just tastes like a spritzer. I don't know. You don't taste any alcohol. It's 6.2 alcohol volume. If I was home, I definitely wouldn't be. I wouldn't have bought this. But just to have something here. Cheers. Some mom style chips. These are good. This is my second bag. But you can definitely buy these at home. I bought these before from World Market. But I think I had the, I know I had the onion flavor. It's 12:25, we're not leaving for another 3 hours, so. And I feel like we've been here quite a while. But it's really only officially day two. Although we got here early, their time on Tuesday. And this is officially day two. We still got like 5 more days to go. Finish watching my video. And then do some editing. Try to do some editing. I have been doing a little by little. But my plan was to have this video edited before I left here.
But we shall see.
It's a few days later. It's a couple days later. And I'm back in the same dress. I know you like, girl, you looking like the other day. Well, that's because I did not leave this room for the past 2 days. I have been down and out. So nobody, I didn't wear this dress outside of this room. I missed the two activities that we had booked. Well, we booked three. I did one out of three. Paid for money down the drain. When I tell you, these fibroids gotta come out of me the way that I bled. I'd never bled like that before. For 2 days straight, non-stop clotting. I'm still bleeding. And it eased up last night before I went to bed. And this morning, then once I got in the shower, I'm flowing again. I'm starting to think it's this dress. Because it started when I first put this dress on. But, yeah, 2 days lost in Hawaii because of my period. And I know people were like, you know, just bring a change of clothes and extra pads. I don't, like, the amount of bleeding, it was nonstop. I started looking up hospitals nearby because I was that scared that I was gonna have to be admitted. Like, literally nonstop. It's no way I could have gone out like that. I'm changing my pad every 20 to 30 minutes. I bought 3 packs of pads since I've been here. And the always diapers. I use these at home to sleep in, but so yeah, that's been the update. So today I'm gonna try to get out. Just to even walk around the resort. Because this room is nice. It's okay, but I didn't come to Hawaii just to sit in the room. I do that enough at home. And my eyes still swollen. That's why I got these glasses on. It's bad. To bring you something back. My family, that's different. But like, co-workers and all that, I don't even mess with y'all like that. This place, this where I work at now, they don't do it often, but still, I hate that. Like, I don't ask people to bring me nothing back. I used to, but I really didn't care if you did or you didn't. Because, like, people go on vacation to vacation. I used to be stressed out trying to find souvenirs for people. I don't do that no more. But yeah, I want to find something for myself. Something that says Hawaii. But I think I'm about to go to Starbucks. Ouch. And get me some of that good coffee. Yeah. I'll talk to you guys. For the night. It's 7:30. Oh, lady gang, I'm in for the night. We got to get up early in the morning to go to a park. We're doing some state park. But yeah. Okay, this thing is doing everything but focusing on me. Can you focus on me? But let me get myself situated, pull out my clothes for tomorrow, get in the shower, all the things. Why? Okay, let me go. It's doing too much. To get out. Well, I'm not even at the mountain. This is the prelude to the mountain. Definitely not making it to the mountain. And some girl said they saw a mongoose. Hell no. This is the last day in Hawaii. Guess where I am? Still in the room. This is the last 4 day. And yeah, I just uploaded a video. And I'm about to maybe start trying to edit the next video. I don't know. But yes, I've spent 90% of my trip in this room due to my fibroids. I'm still bleeding. I spoke with the doctor. He told me to double up on a medication. And I've been saying it's a birth control. It's not a birth control. It's just a medication that helps, that's supposed to minimize bleeding, but I am bleeding even more. So yeah, yesterday I attempted to hike a mountain. I got really far, as far as I thought I would, because initially I was going to quit before I even got to the mountain. I don't know why this thing does that. Focus on me. Yeah, so I got hella far, but I started feeling things and I was like, I better turn around. And for me, it's harder to come down than going up, because I get nervous that I'm like slip and fall. So, but I was proud of myself that I got that far. My sister went all the way to the top. So once you get to the mountain part, stairs, you got to go up the stairs. She went all the way to the top, which I knew she would, because she's very active and outdoorsy type. So but I was proud that I got to the point that I did get. But anyway, once I got back to the beginning point, I had to use the restroom, and then my stomach started hurting so bad, like extremely bad. So we came back to the hotel and I just stayed in the hotel the rest of the time, because you know why at this point. So yeah, just the last day. I'm pretty much already packed. It's early. It's 10:17. But I'm pretty much packed. I just have to pack up, you know, the stuff that I wore, that I'm wearing today, and my night clothes. Do that in the morning after I shower, and yeah, I'll be good to go. We leave kind of late though, speaking of which, I think we leave around 3, or our flight leaves at 3, and we can check in 4 hours, say. Yeah, we leave at 3:15 tomorrow, and we get back 9 a.m. Wednesday, because you know the time difference is a 6-hour time difference. So, but that's the update. I'm just very disappointed that I didn't get a chance to enjoy my vacation. I cried. I cried some more. But it was out of my control. So I'm not going anywhere until I have some type of surgery. I'm not dealing with this again. Like, I won't say it was a complete waste. Well, me missing the excursions was definitely in the luau. That's the main thing I wanted to see. That was definitely a waste of money. But I won't say the whole trip was wasted. I mean, I got a chance to relax. But I didn't need 8 days in here for that. I wish I could have at least had 4 days to do something. All right, y'all. I just got some food. I got Jollibee. I had to come all the way to Hawaii for Jollibee because we have one. We have two in the DMV area, but they're not close to me. And it was a Jollibee close by here, so I was like, let me try it. So I just got. Let me show you. I just got fried chicken and fries. I know they, camera, it just be going whatever way it wants to. But I used to have Filipino co-workers and they raved over Jollibee because I think it originates from the Philippines. So yeah, let's taste the fries. Oh my god. It's a little cold. Still. It just tastes like fries. And I just got a two-piece original and spicy. And the spicy they put. This. Oh, come on. They put the little stick to indicate, but you can tell it's spicy because it's red. Not bad. They got a nice crunch to it. Not bad. Oh yeah, that's it. I also got the mango peach pie. I'll tell you how that was. Okay, so I just finished. I forgot that it also came with gravy that I didn't eat because I don't really eat gravy. But it was okay. I would get it again if I came across it again. But it's nothing that, you know, I would be craving. Especially because. Especially because, focus on me. I gotta fix this, DJI thing because, yeah. But, because the chicken is like really fatty. Like the skin has a nice crisp to it and crunch, but the chicken itself is fatty. I don't like fatty chicken. I also don't eat dark meat, and they gave me two pieces of dark meat. That's probably why it was fatty. You don't get it, at least on Uber Eats. That's how I ordered it. You don't get a chance to choose the pieces of chicken you want. So, yeah. But it was all right for what it was, but it wasn't all that. And then I got me, I went to the little ABC store to get souvenirs. I got like a handful of souvenirs that came up to $80. Like, that's why I wanted to go off of the resort, but I was stuck. But anyway, I got this little lychee cooler. I had it the other day. It was okay. But it's like a nice refreshing drink. And then let's try this peach mango pie together. I'm not even a pie person, but when I tell you, my coworkers, one in particular, she used to rave about this. She is a foodie. She loved food, but she used to rave about this. She used to rave about Jollibees in general, but especially this pie and a spaghetti. I don't eat beef or pork, so I couldn't get the spaghetti. Let's eat. Pretty good. I like it because it's not too sweet. I thought it was gonna be hella sweet. And it's not, so that's good. Oh yeah, I would do Jollibees again. I just hope that they can do like some chicken breasts, even a wing, because I don't like a thigh. I can do a drumstick. I could do a Popeye's drumstick, but yeah. In my Keith Lee fashion, I would rate it chicken. A chicken is like a 6 out of 10 for me, only because of the dark meat. Fries, 3 out of 10. They were just fries. This peach mango pie, I would say 7 out of 10. So yeah, I could do Jollibees again. I don't work with those co-workers anymore, but I still keep in contact with one of them, so I'm gonna let her know that I finally tried Jollibees. But yeah, so let me finish watching my YouTube. The same thing I would be doing at home. And I will talk to you guys later. I'm such a mess.